What is going on, guys? If you're new here, I'm Oliver, and if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button to join my channel. And yeah, guys, I know it has been a hot minute since I've uploaded. Said that it wouldn't take forever for me to upload again.
Don't worry, I'm not gonna like take a break again. I will be cracking on with this.
That one didn't age quite so well.
But what can I say? I mean, the last, what is it now, like 5 months? They just kind of disappeared. I mean, I've been working on the Batman film a lot. Apologies if, by the way, when I do move, you hear like lots of Lego cluttering sounds. That would be because I've actually slightly upended my set right now just to quickly make this video. But yeah, it has been a moment, and I do apologize. I would say I'm going to try and upload more consistently, but knowing me, that's just not going to happen. But yeah, I am back with what will most likely be the final part of my Lego Batman minifigure series. I will definitely make more customs, but I think this is kind of the end of what I wanted to make. I've got all the big villains. And I mean, I've updated a few, but you know, some have just not really been worth showing. Like, for example, I mean, we've got Bane here, who, like, you know, he looks cool, but I just didn't think he was worth including because, you know, we've already got a Bane in the last one, and, you know, he doesn't look, like, massively different. And, you know, it's just, it's a lot. So, my point being, I've got a lot of customs, but I think I'll maybe just give them their own video as opposed to including this. Them in the series. But anyway, yeah, so for this video, guys, I have got going from left to right, I have got Red Hood, Two-Face, Deathstroke, and Scarecrow. So I think without further ado, let's get into it. All right, guys, so starting off with Scarecrow here. Honestly, most of these have been quite simple customs, kind of going back to how the series started out with only a few pieces being custom. That, of course, being the head and the scythe, along with also the cape. But yeah, the legs are just the, I believe, the Avengers Infinity War Gamora legs. And then the torso is, oh, I forget the name. They are, they're from a Star Wars character. I forgot the name of. And then the arms are from the Lego Batman movie Scarecrow. The cape is then, I believe, a modified Mandalorian Scarecrow. No, a modified Mandalorian cape that I then just kind of cut down to size. Now, as for his scyther, basically what I did is I just took and I just took the took a sword from a Lego CMF Goblin minifigure, and I just cut it and glued it together to give him this comedically large scythe. And then his kind of, I don't know what to call it, glove, I guess, which is off obviously based off of the Arkham games. Basically, I just cut the kind of wrist piece off of a Lego handcuff piece. And then I just gave him some Wolverine claws to kind of simulate the syringes on his hands. but then, sorry, I do realize I keep lifting him out of frame, which is not very helpful. But then his face, basically that's just a regular kind of beigey face. I don't really know what the technical term is for it. But I just painted all of that. So the black is actually Sharpie. And then I did all the, painted on all the stitching, added on his, white eyes. And yeah, that's really kind of it. But yeah, rather simple custom, but I think it's relatively effective. So let's move on to the next one. So next up we have the most recently made out of, all of them. And that is, of course, Deathstroke. So, Deathstroke's a bit of an interesting one, of course. I already made a version of him in the original video, but he wasn't really custom. He was just a bunch of pieces that I already had that I just amalgamated together. So I figured, let's make a custom this time. So his head basically was just a regular old head that I then sculpted onto with blue tack and then just hardened with clay. Maybe not the most professional technique, but it certainly gets the job done. And I just sculpted onto that and then painted it all up. So I gave it the black, the orange, and the black going all around the other side. Then I just gave him some regular black arms. His legs were black legs that I then painted the grey strap onto along with the blue shoes. Or boots, whatever you want them to be. I then gave him a sword sheath. And his sword actually is custom. It's a modified Mega Bloks katana. I just shortened the end, so basically took off the end little nubbin, so it just got shortened down and looked more like a Lego katana. And then the shoulder pad, if I'm being completely honest, I have absolutely no idea where it's from. Yeah, I genuinely have no clue. I couldn't even really tell you if it was a Lego piece. But yeah, I stuck it and then just glued it onto the shoulder. And then his vest is like a Lego Batman movie vest. Funnily enough, for those of you who have been watching for a while, you may remember I made that Punisher video a while back. Custom Lego Punisher. And basically what I did is I just took one of the Lego Batman movie police vests and I cut the back off of it so he could basically wear like a trench coat and stuff. But basically that meant that I had a back piece that I found recently that I didn't have anything to do with, so I instead glued it onto the torso of Deathstroke and then painted some orange onto. And then after that I gave it some like dry brushes of silver along with giving the mask some dry brushes of, some washes of black and then some dry brushes of silver. But yeah, not the most complex, but probably the most customized here, the most not purist, should I say. So yeah, let's move on to the next one. Alright guys, so here we have Two-Face. Now, if I am being completely honest, this guy went through many, many different changes. In fact, basically there was another Two-Face minifigure that I was going to include in this video. But I instead gave him a complete design overhaul. I do still like the original figure, but this figure kind of serves a bit more of a purpose, and that is because his torso, basically, I always wanted to be able to make my own Two-Face torso. I wanted to have my own design printed onto a Lego minifigure. I just thought, like, officially printed onto a Lego minifigure. I thought that would be really cool. So recently, I visited Legoland in Windsor, and they had one of their own build your own minifigure stations there, and so I got two of the same torsos and then just made one for Two-Face and one for Harvey Dent. So we do have a Harvey Dent and a Two-Face. But Harvey Dent's pretty simple. He's just got the Superman hairpiece, but with the S curve or curl chopped off. The face is then just the new Batman 1989 polybag Batman head. Out of focus though, but on the Bruce Wayne side. And then the torso is just the custom printed one, although it's not actually my own design. And then the legs are just regular black legs, obviously. But moving back on to this figure, so I basically got the torso printed, and then after that I just cut the side off of a Superman hairpiece along with the S swirl in his hair, and then I painted up the one side of it in white, and then gave it a kind of black. I think it was either dry brush or wash, if I'm being completely honest. I don't remember. But then his legs are just standard black legs. His coin, if you have a look here, is actually a cut Lego bar. I just kind of cut like the very tip off of it. Now the face is a Star Wars Lego trooper face. And then I just painted half of it, so I basically gave him the exposed teeth and the bad eye and all the scarring and stuff. But it was just lots of pinks and reds and oranges and washes and all that stuff. But yeah, I also painted on the white eyebrow because I thought it would be a cool little homage to the Batman the Animated Series one. And then, of course, I gave painted up his hand to kind of match. But other than that, yeah, that's really kind of it for Two-Face. So yeah, let's move on to our final custom. So I was half debating whether I should actually put him in this video, considering the fact that after he kind of, after the Under the Red Hood story is done for, he kind of just becomes an anti-hero. But I figured he has an antagonistic enough relationship with Batman that I think I could probably put him in a video like this and get away with it. So we have Red Hood. So straight off the bat, I think it's important to mention that obviously he only has one custom piece here, and that is the helmet. But yeah, so before we get to that, the legs are, they're just some blue and brown dual molded legs, which I then gave a belt hip piece to. And then the torso is just the Nightmare Batman torso from the miniature set. And then if I take off the helmet, the head is just the scarred Kylo Ren head, which then I just thought, I mean, you can use any hairpiece, but this one kind of works quite well with it. But yeah. But then the helmet piece basically is a Batman, no, not Batman, Iron Man helmet piece that I just basically took all the printing off of and then painted it in my own tone of red. And then just gave it lots of washes of black and then gave it some dry brushes of silver. And then basically I outlined the edges in black. And then just kind of almost just took some of it off while it was drying. And that kind of created this kind of worn look that it has. But yeah, really that's all that there is to say on it. I mean, yeah, pretty simple custom, but I think it gets the job done quite well. So let's wrap this video up. All right, guys, so I think that brings an end to the video, and with it, the Batman custom minifigure series. I just want to give a big thanks for all of you who had the patience to stick around over this ridiculously long journey. I'm not going to lie, I did procrastinate on a good bit of it. But also, you know, I've been working on lots of things, lots of projects have been taking up my time. And also school, blech. But you know. It takes up a lot of time too, but I will try not to take 5 months to upload again, but you know, no promises, as has been proven. But yeah, really that's all I have to say for the video. So if you liked, make sure to drop a like, and please consider subscribing. It would mean a lot to the channel. And yeah, make sure to stick around, because there are films coming your way. Along with hopefully more custom videos. But yeah, really, I think that's all I have to say. So until next time, guys, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. See you all in the next one. Bye, guys.